Now in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make stunning websites with awesome animations without any use of coding knowledge.
And that's all easily possible with the no-code website building tool, Framer. And Framer is one of the fastest growing and most popular tools in the website design world. And you'll soon agree just how awesome it is when I show you the three best tips and features that I personally use in Framer. And for the first best feature I make use of when it comes to using Framer, we have quick access to easy and awesome animations on Framer. So on this project right here, where I'm playing with a portfolio layout, we can quickly test run the site with a play icon. And as you can see, this Contact Now CTA has a sweet overlay animation. And yeah, it looks cool, but let's add some other animations really quickly onto my website. And this is how easy it is with Framer. On this text, we just come into the effects tabs found here. And as you can see, there are a bunch of different types of animations that we can use. But for now, let's run with the hover effect first. And so down here, we have settings that will dictate the scale, the rotation, and other aspects of my animation. But importantly for me right here at the very bottom, we can control the smoothness of the animation. So instead of being a constant animation, we can ease in or ease out or even both. Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and test run this right now. As you can see, my text is disappearing at the top and the bottom edges, and that's because I need to resize the bounding box. And now I've rectified that box issue, and after adding another hover animation to both lines of text, we have this quick and cool animation ready to use. But hey, let's add something even more cool in terms of animations. So we have this flame icon here, and let's go ahead and add a loop animation. So loop animations rotate the graphic in a constant loop, hence the name loop. But we can add a delay, and then also maybe an ease setting. And that helps things not look so bland, generic, and boring. Now we can see the flame is looping like so, and this kind of animation works really well for CTAs or other aspects of your site that you want people to notice and to gravitate towards. So the next feature I've been finding highly useful in Framer is something that is highly intuitive and makes a lot of sense, and that is the stacks feature. But before that, I quickly want to show you something I do love in Framer. Notice how I can change the image here and it changes independently of the other sites. But I can set things up, such as on the text here. So if I adjust my typography itself, it will actually change across my entire site variation layouts. And there, yeah, as you can see, I have a laptop version, a tablet version, a phone version, and a desktop version of my website, all in one really neat workspace. But anyway, stacks. Here I have some typography and that flame animation from earlier. If we select everything and then right or control click, we can add it all into a stack. But why would we actually want to do this? Well, for a few reasons actually. First, we can consider this now a grouped design asset. And from that, we can control the micro white space between the objects with the gap setting here. We can also add padding to the entire stack as well, which is always nice to do. But we can also adjust the individual padding settings as well if that's something you need to work with. And as you can see, we are able to move the entire stack around a website with ease. But hey, what about the style of this stack? Well, Framer obviously has us covered. We can add effects right here, adjust the color and transparency of the stack background itself, and you might even want to drop that opacity down to 0%, which for me is often the case, but not right now. But yeah, we have a whole bunch of settings here that can help us customize and format our stacks. And it's just a very neat and intuitive way to work with proximity design assets on your websites. So the next aspect of Framer that I find so helpful appeals to me personally for two different reasons. Firstly, because I have no knowledge of coding, but also secondly, it saves me a lot of time. And what can appeal to both of those facts? Templates. And to access those templates, head over to framer.com/templates. There are so many here to make use of, and I'm going to show you exactly why they rock. So at the very top here, we have grouped niche sectors. And so if you want to work on a landing page project, just come into the landing page section. But anyway, here we have the new and fresh templates hot off the press. But scrolling down a bit further, we can toggle these settings here. And yeah, let's browse those free templates only. And I do often use the most popular setting here. But as you can see, there are some very neat and decent looking templates to choose from. And considering these are all free, it's pretty cool. And clicking onto this template here, we can see how it looks and scroll over some of the possible pages. But to use any template as a project, simply click right here and away you go. It's so cool that these templates often have the same website, but in various different formats ready to rock and roll. And on the left here, you can access the different formats and then the subsequent layers of each site variation. And that's one thing I find with Framer. It's so cleanly laid out. And that's something you probably should expect from a software that does design websites.
And so to start your journey making awesome and stunning websites just like in today's video, head over to Framer via the link down below and also use my promo code for a sweet discount. And until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.